wanted to test if novel virtual reality technology, the kind of films displayed on these head-mounted displays, if it's feasible, if it's safe to place on this population who are frail older adults with cognitive, sensory, and mobility impairments. These are often people living with Alzheimer's and dementia. We were very happy to find that over 75% of participants were able to go through the intervention, which was about 20 minutes of virtual reality. There was initially a very big concern that people couldn't tolerate the weight of the headset, but there were no negative side effects reported, no motion sickness, no dizziness, no adverse events. So really we've established that it's pretty much safe to use this kind of technology. It's a very hopeful alternative for some more detrimental therapies that are applied when trying to manage behavioral and psychological symptoms of dementia. We all know that dementia and Alzheimer's is going to be a growing concern for our society. It's not only psychologically problematic for families, but it's expensive for our entire system. And so we're trying to find healthier ways to manage behavioral and psychological symptoms. So we want to see if less invasive therapies can be just as beneficial. And so we've really found that, yes, there is an avenue and potential for this therapy. We have upcoming studies looking at if personal caregivers, families, and friends can provide the therapy. And there's, you know, potential with other populations as well. Palliative care is very interested. Children with autism might have potential. So it's really a growing field. I really am happy to have the opportunity to involve students and teach them about research methods and participate really in a lot of the data collection of my research. And I do hope to start a lab at York that deals with a lot of these interventions.